justify, but probably under current circumstances, a downgrade is not. And the United States has certain really great strengths that tend to get ignored, particularly in the marketplace, which right now is just reacting with fear to all of this.
And what would those strengths be?
Well, the most diversified industrial-based and most diversified economic base in the world today by a long shot. The United States remains an almost $15 trillion economy. It's at least 2.5 times the size of the next country, if you will, in terms of wealth. The United States has a reasonably highly educated workforce. The United States has the world's most prominent reserve currency. All of these are tremendous advantages that nobody else does. And it's worth keeping in mind that productivity in this country, that is in the U.S., remains as strong, if not stronger, than virtually any other industrialized country at the present time. Labor mobility remains at extraordinary by world standards. One could go on and on. So I'm not dismissing the fiscal problems of the U.S. They're serious. They have to be addressed. But let's not forget as well the underlying strengths that led the United States to a AAA status. And that's really key in all of this.
Well, when we talk about the risk, though, I mean, in your view, if Congress does not come to some sort of agreement and you do see the debt to GDP continue to climb, as Standard & Poor's says it could, to about 84% by 2013, what is the biggest sort of fallout risk from that happening to the U.S. economy?
In the event that the fiscal situation continues to deteriorate, then again, a 1 in 3 chance that the United States gets downgraded. If that happens, and I would stress to you that I think it's unlikely, but if it were to happen, then U.S. borrowing costs would go up to a certain degree as well. There's no reason to believe that it's not even worth talking about the United States as having default risk. The United States will still be one of the most solid credits in the world today, but in the event of a one-notch downgrade, it will be a AA+. It's still extremely high, just not the highest level. There would be a cost in terms of borrowing costs, therefore, a cost to the U.S. in terms of prestige as well. Mm-hmm. U.S. and Americans in general take real pride in the fact that this is a strong AAA credit, as we call it, in the world today, one of the most creditworthy countries in the world. So there's this prestige issue, too, that I don't think should be dismissed. Also, there's some U.S. government-owned agencies that would likely see their credit rating downgraded from AAA to also AA+, thereby increasing their borrowing costs, too. So the costs to the U.S. are not insignificant, both in terms of financial cost, but also in terms of psychological or prestige-related costs. It's not the end of the world, but it would certainly hurt. But that said, I would stress S&P's not doing this anytime soon. And they may not do it at all. In fact, the likelihood is they won't. It's just sort of a kick in the rear end to policymakers now that they have to get their act together and reach a reasonable compromise that will allay the concerns of the ratings agencies, and even more important than the agencies, allay the concerns of the broader market.
And Jonathan, quickly here, I'm just curious, I mean, do you think that this S&P outlook is enough to tip the scales in Washington?
No, I think it's one signal, and a credit rating agency report in and of itself has some impact. Today, it's all the news. Tomorrow, we'll move on to something else. It's